Hi everyone, I'm Chris Young. Behind the camera we have Dave Leneff. And what we have in front of you are our three lines of inspection. So these are all in our XR75 platform. They all share the same exact software and they have a lot of common parts. This is our standard single energy XR7534. This is our dual energy or DualX 7534. And this is our brand new DualX Plus 7534. So what's unique about this is it has a whole new imaging system. It is our third generation of dual energy or DualX inspection. What we have on the screen is we have a large package of nuts. It's a 48 ounce bag. We actually have two metal contaminant cards on it, a wire in the upper left of the image, and then in the lower right hand side, small metal balls. So starting at the first machine, which is the single energy, you'll see that we detected very good metal down to 0.4 millimeter diameter and 0.7 millimeter sphere. Excellent detection in a large product, running at 40 meters a minute, so good line speed. Next machine, the DualX, it moves the bar a little bit further, so the same wire, 0.4, but now all the way down to 0.5 millimeter stainless steel sphere. Okay. Now the DualX Plus, this is actually a higher resolution image, and you're gonna see it pay dividends on small metal. So we picked up another level of metal detection that's 0.3 wire diameter and 0.4 sphere. So pretty incredible levels of detection in a bag that's about 65 millimeters thick as it passes through the X-ray machine. Okay, but really the number one complaint that you're gonna get in field harvest products or nuts is soft contaminants, glass and rock. So the next test we're gonna do is we're gonna put glass cards on. We're going to do a synthetic quartz and also a soda lime glass and show you the comparisons across the product stack. All right, so we're back. We just ran the same product again, but now we have low density contaminants, a quartz, and then soda lime glass. Now we actually recommend that you use quartz as a low density contaminant because it is more consistent in its density levels on the cards, but it is a little bit harder to find. So this one will be harder to find. It's lower density than the glass. So when we look at the standard machine here, we notice we see two of the quartz, which is 5 millimeter diameter. And we actually see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 glass balls, which is down to 3 millimeter. So again, for a standard machine, that's excellent detection. Now when moving to the dual energy, we see we have picked up on the quartz detection, now down to 3 millimeter, which is actually two more contaminants. And the glass ball, now we have picked up all six and down to 2 millimeter. For an application like nuts looking for low density contaminant, you really want to use DualX, either the standard DualX or DualX Plus. And now if we go to the last machine here, we see that we even picked up more quartz. We got all five down to 2 millimeter quartz and as well 2 millimeter glass. So again, excellent detection and really ultimate detection provided by the new DualX Plus. So now we're back. We have a new product. We're running a much thinner bag. This one is a combination of nuts and berries, and it's only 20 millimeters thick. Okay. And we're back running the metal test card. So again, small wire and small sphere. If we look on the screen, again, on our standard single energy unit, we did very well. All the way down to 0.4 millimeter diameter wire. And then on the right-hand side, we're down to 0.6 millimeter sphere, running at 40 meters a minute. So again, good line speed. Next machine here, our DualX, did even better. So we're at 0.4 millimeter wire, and now down to 0.5 millimeter sphere. Last machine, the DualX Plus, got every single contaminant on both cards. So all the way down to 0.2 millimeter wire, and 0.3 millimeter sphere stainless steel. Really impressive performance. Okay, now we're gonna go ahead and switch out the cards, run the glass and the quartz again. So just give us 1 second. Okay, so we're back. We just ran this product with the quartz on the upper left and the glass on the lower right. Again, the quartz is a little more difficult to find due to the fact it has slightly less density. So our standard system did an excellent job. It actually found all six of the glass down to 2 millimeter. And on the quartz, it missed the 3 millimeter, but actually found the 2 millimeter. And the reason why it missed one and found the other is just because depending on where this lands in the product, it can be a little more difficult to find. That's where the dual energy comes in. The dual energy does an excellent job regardless of where the contaminant lies in the product. It's really the ideal solution to look for low density contaminants. And what we're gonna see on this next one, the dual energy or DualX, is it found all of the contaminants. So 2 millimeter quartz on the left, 2 millimeter glass on the right. The DualX Plus as well found all the contaminants. And really now we're down to the detection level that's actually beyond the smallest spheres on our cards. So we're gonna have to find a little bit smaller test cards. But these two machines can do an excellent job, as we've just seen, on thinner or thicker products. Ideal solution for looking for any types of stones or rocks and things like nuts or snacks, ground harvest crops, including potatoes or french fries. But all three of these machines will be at PAC Expo. Hopefully we'll see you there. Thank you.